Hi everybody, today I want to show you the simple and realistic elevator design. So by realistic I mean you don't get punched upwards by pistons or get shot through air by slime blocks. We actually have a cabin like for real elevator. You just need to press this button here and you would go upwards. And you can also go downwards again, so it's a two-way elevator. The system is quite simple and compact and can be adjusted to basically any size. So we use a two-way flying machine that actually goes through the elevator shaft. So the nice thing about 1.12 are those new glazed terracotta blocks, which don't stick to the slime blocks. So previously we would need to use obsidian or something like droppers or furnaces to make a shaft for the elevator. But now we can just use those terracotta blocks, which in my opinion look a lot nicer. The redstone is quite minimalistic, so you just need a station at the bottom and top for the elevator. I also made a version where you could call the elevator. So at the moment the elevator is at the bottom, but by pressing this button we can send it upwards. And the same goes if you're standing at the bottom, the elevator is up there, you can also call it from the bottom. And here's how you can build it. So I'll start with the basic version first, and at the end of the tutorial I'll add the optional calling function to the elevator. So 5 blocks below our entry level, we place down a non-movable block, for example obsidian or a dropper, then we can remove that again, and we build the flying machine next. So we need 2 slime blocks here, then upwards and a downwards facing piston. Can also already add an observer here. Then 2 more slime blocks here and another sticky piston on top. Then 2 more slime blocks here. And for the cabin, I would suggest to use wool because it has the same color and you can use the carpet here. Of course, you could also leave it empty, but I guess it just looks nicer if you cover the slime blocks. So then while we add components to the flying machine, we put a non-movable block at the top so it doesn't launch. Then we add an observer right here and another observer right here. They both face into the slime blocks. Okay, so next we'll add some blocks around the elevator, which is kind of optional. You don't really need them, but I think it looks nicer if you just place some blocks around your elevator cabin. So here where everything that would potentially touch a slime block in its path, you need to use blocks that don't stick to slime blocks, which would be glazed terracotta and something like obsidian or furnaces in 1.11. So here you don't need to use those, but you could also use them if you want to make a nice 2x2 pattern, for example. And so next we need a redstone lamp and a block we can put a button on, and then we place an observer below the redstone lamp which detects the redstone lamp changing, then a sticky piston below and an observer facing this way, and here we have a solid block and a powered rail on top below redstone dust and a repeater on 4 ticks. Okay, then you can build this as high as you need it, so just repeat this pattern. You can also put glass blocks in front, which I think looks quite nice, which I did for my model, but it's kind of optional what you do here. Just build this up as high as you want. Meanwhile, you can also remove this obsidian block. So I built up the elevator up to this height, but it's totally optional how long your elevator is. So next, what we need to do is build the station at the top, but I want to explain it first a little bit. So I didn't want to stop the elevator by a non-movable block like obsidian because that would look a little bit ugly. That's why, in order to stop the elevator, we keep this piston here extended. So this observer here at the bottom would trigger this sticky piston right here, which pushes up those slime blocks, which keeps this block powered, which causes the piston to stay extended. So we can see it here. You can see, and this stops the elevator. Now, in order to send the elevator back down again, we just activate a button here at the top, and this pushes the slime block structure and the redstone block on top down, and also the subserver gets moved down. So this piston here would retract again, and the observer here would power the sticky piston that is facing downwards, and this causes the flying machine to fly back down again. Alright, here's how you can build the top part. You need to attach a button to this block at the back. Then at the back of the block, place down two slabs, put some redstone dust on top, and then you need a piston below it. Then two blocks lower, put down a redstone block, and three slime blocks below, and normal piston facing upwards. Then again, you need a block that isn't grabbed by slime blocks, like this glazed terracotta block or obsidian. Put a repeater on top, and then we add an observer here. Then we need some solid blocks again. Put it down here, and a sticky piston two blocks below. Then add a block here, some redstone dust on top, and here we need a powered rail again. So the elevator should be working now. Can also send it down. And the next step, I'll show you how to build the calling system. So first we build a system that sends a signal upwards. So we place an observer here that detects the other observer. It powers a non-sticky block. Then we need a dropper here and a hopper. Put one item into the hopper. Then again, a non-sticky block and a comparator on top. Then a sticky piston and an observer on top. Then just need some normal solid blocks. And we build a chain upwards. So I use this block door observer system because it's the fastest way to transfer a signal upwards. You could also use wooden doors instead, but you need to consider that wooden doors might mess with some village systems you have. So only use wooden doors if you don't have an iron farm next to it or uniribit crop farm. Okay. Of course, if you could also use just observers, for example, but this is just the fastest way to transfer signal upwards. Okay, so all we gotta do is power this piston here. I guess one more iteration. Then we can take an output from here. Power this block. Put a dust on top. And a repeater. If you build this, for example, one block lower, whatever, then just need to adjust the system, but it shouldn't be too hard. Okay. Then we also need to make a system that goes downwards. So it's basically the same. So we just need an observer again. Build it right here. Dust on top. And now the downwards chain, which is quite similar. So again, block, door, observer. So here at the bottom, we just need to power the sticky piston here. So we use two blocks, repeaters on top, we use a non-sticky block, and power this block here, and put a dust on top. So in order to reach this block here, I just left out an iron block, and place the door directly under the next observer, so this adds up, so we can easily reach it. If you have another height, then might need to adjust this slightly. Okay, so that's it. Hope you found this tutorial useful. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day. Bye bye.